Welcome to Ham Shack Reviews. My name is Vince, and today I'm going to do a quick tutorial on how to download N1MM Logger. The first thing you want to do is open a browser and type in N1MM and hit that. You'll see it's be the top choice here, Logger Plus. Make sure you get the plus because that's the current one. Click that. And you open up on N1MM's page. Up here is the downloads, but I want to show you this down here. This gives you a quick guide into the features, and this one goes directly to the beginning of the get started section. Go back up, click program files under downloads, click full install. I already got it in, so I'm not going to install it. Okay, when it opens up, you should have these two windows. If not, then you'll go up here to Windows. You'll scroll down and you'll see you got these different windows you can open. They can all be open while you're using it or just the ones you need. I am on the CQ Worldwide CW contest. It's the last one I did. You'll have this here as your bottom. I like to bring them together. And then so let's say you type in a call. You type in AG4... EA and you hit tab, it takes you to the next field. It puts in your sent, your received, and your CQ zone, and then you just hit enter, and there it is. There's your first contact. Now when you want to pick your contest, you come up here to file, click new login database, and then it opens up. Now you can either spin it here like this, or I prefer to click it. And it's a lot easier to read this way. And all these are contests. I think this program has the most contests you could do. And sometimes there's ones that are not in here that you could put in here. This does have a little bit of a learning curve, but it works smoothly. It gives you the most contests. And it just works. And that's what you want in a logger. And when you get in here, you hit configure ports and modes. And you want to get top one's COM3, Azu FTDX 3000 is what I have. And then you hit set. I left them both blank, and then you hit set. And now this opens up over here. You got your baud rate, your data bits 8 and 1, your DTR or RTS. And then you got some other choices here. I haven't used any of these. And then you hit OK. And that says setting up radio and band map. Okay, next you'll go up to Windows, and all these are windows you can open, or there's some other features. The band map, that's what you opened on the other screen. I'm going to bring it over. You can resize it. When you got this working, it'll show you where people are at and give you their call sign, and you can see the frequency. You can click Window again, and you can hit CW Reader. Click OK. And I guess down here it should read your CW. I didn't even know it had this feature. Then you go back up the windows again. And here's one I like. It's the gray line. Let me just slide this out the way. Now this gives you the gray line. So I'm here in Jersey right now. I'm blacked out. It doesn't mean I can't talk, but it means I won't have the gray line working with me until this line here gets over New Jersey. And that's all I have tonight. This was a quick intro. I'll do more on each subject later on. Please subscribe, ding that bell, and give me a like or a share. Thank you, and 73.